For our scripture reading today, let us turn to Psalm 147, verses 1 to 11. Psalm 147, verses 1 to 11. Praise the Lord! How good it is to sing praises to our God! How pleasant and fitting to praise Him! The Lord builds up Jerusalem. He gathers the exiles of Israel. He heals the brokenhearted and binds up their wounds. He determines the number of the stars and calls them each by name. Great is our Lord and mighty in power. His understanding has no limit. The Lord sustains the humble, but adds the rich to the ground. Sing to the Lord with thanksgiving. Make music to our God on the harp. He covers the sky with clouds. He supplies the earth with rain. He makes grass grow on the hills. He provides food for the cattle and for the young ravens when they call. His pleasure is not in the strength of the horse, nor his delight in the legs of man. The Lord delights in those who fear him, who put their hope in his unfailing love. Let us bow in prayer. Heavenly Father, what a joy to come into your presence today. Father, this psalm has exhorted us to sing praises unto you, for you're so worthy of our praise. Father, we're so thankful that you fashioned and designed these bodies of ours and has given us voices to praise you. And Father, we just are so thankful that as we go through this worship service today and sing these songs and hear these ones that have come to minister to us, that our hearts would be drawn nearer to you. Father, we just invite you into our midst now, and that our worship could bring you glory and praise. And we pray these things in Jesus' holy name. Amen.
Thank you. come to worship with us today. They're here to minister music, but it is a time of worship as they sing, because they will lead us to the throne of God and encourage us through not only their music, but also through their testimony. It's Brian and Rachel, that's mom and dad, and I think Lauren and Charlotte and Brianna, right? Then the boys, Micah, Isaac, and Caleb. Then Sadie. But there was one woman. Who am I missing? What's your name? You don't have a name? The fuller with no name. Do you sing?
Jesus this morning. And some days we need him lean a little harder than other days, but we need him every day. And I trust you're leaning on him today. Well, as has been mentioned, we are the Fuller Family Singers. And he got all of our names, so I don't have to introduce ourselves. But I will just take a moment to introduce a little bit, because we'll fill in a little bit more details. Of course, I am Brian. And we live in Mount Pleasant Mills, Pennsylvania, Snyder County. And that's about 2 hours, I guess it'd be south from here. And we live on a little farmette there where we do a bunch of different things, including raise some cattle and have some cattle, some horses. And we also have an auctioneering business. We auction full-time there. And then, of course, we travel and sing. We've been blessed to sing in many different places. This past year, we've been in, well, I shouldn't say how many places we've been because I don't know if I remember them all, but I know we've been in New York and North Carolina several times, and we just got back from Alabama and Georgia just 2 weeks ago, and we're headed to Ohio, West Virginia next week, Ohio, New York, and Florida yet this year. So those are some places we've been or going to be. We're looking forward to being able to minister in prisons in Florida. We've got 4 different prisons that we're going to be going in. Most of the children, the two oldest boys and the 3 oldest girls, will be able to go behind bars. And we'll be taking this setup and going in and sharing in prisons, 4 different prisons, over the course of 4 days in December, the first week of December. So we're looking forward to that. And then also a men's recovery center, a drug recovery, alcohol recovery center in Ohio that we're singing at for the first time this year. And so we thank God for allowing us these wonderful opportunities of ministry, because we don't want to just get up and sing and just be pure entertainment. It's fine to have good Christian entertainment. There's nothing wrong with that. But we also want to draw people closer to God and be a reflection what we can be when we live for him. And so we appreciate the opportunity to be here, and thank you for coming. It's not very much fun to sing to an empty church, but we got people out there this morning, so thank you so much for coming and sharing in this time. I introduce my wife, Rachel, and she's mom. She is 28. No, I'm just kidding. I'm not going to tell your age. I don't know, but she's pretty much the one that keeps everything, she's the glue that keeps everything together, all right? When I say glue, I mean it's she really has her hands full in scheduling and homeschooling and involved in our businesses and so forth, so she does a lot, and on top of all that, she's having a baby, and so Lord willing, in March of this coming year, we'll have another addition to our band.
Well, over to my left is our oldest daughter, Lauren. She is 18 years old. She finished her senior year of high school earlier this year, and she helps out a lot with our auction business, doing a lot of work with the computer part of the business, and then this year she is starting to get into breeding horses.
Over at the banjo is Charlotte. She is 17 and she plays banjo and occasionally the ukulele, and she has an interest in photography.
Down on the violin is Brianna. She plays our fiddle and occasionally the bass. She is 15 years old and she helps me a lot with the auctioneering business.
Well, underneath the bass is Micah. He is 12 years old and he is our bass and harmonica player.
Over on the mandolin is Isaac and he is 11.
Down on the end is Caleb. He is 9 and he is in 4th grade.
Down my left is Sadie and she is 6. She is 1st grade.
Over down there is Jensen. He is 3.
Thank you.
song, and this one talks about being thankful. And we're really rapidly approaching to this time of the year where we especially want to remember the blessings of the Lord, but truly all year long we need to be thankful because we have so much to thank the Lord for. Song. You know, it's kind of a fun, upbeat song, but I'm glad that someday we're going to leave this world with all of our troubles and all of our trials, and we're going to a much better place than we've ever known down here.
Thank you.
priest, and someday we can go to heaven with him.
My sorrow I fell, and Jesus came and listened. song that says, "All my life has been rearranged." I'm so thankful that when Jesus comes into our life, he doesn't just leave us in our sin and leave us in all of our misery and all of our problems, but he comes and he changes and transforms us and makes us a brand new creature in Christ Jesus. We're going to sing a song now about expectations. And, you know, we're at a time of the year where we expect some changes, right? We've been all expecting and anticipating that this time of the year the leaves are going to change colors and fall off the trees. And we're experiencing that right now. You came to church with expectations. You expected that we were going to show up and be here. You've been wondering what was going on if we hadn't showed up. And we go through life, and there are some things that we can honestly expect that are not very pleasant. Sooner or later, we're going to have problems in our life. We really shouldn't be shocked if we have problems or if we have trials, and sooner or later we have some sorrow. And but sometimes in life, we can go through life where we living life that we only expect and we are only looking for those negative things. And that's not the way Christ wants us to live. Because even though we can, yes, we can expect to have problems, he doesn't want our minds and our hearts to be focused on the problems that we're going to face. But he wants us to be expecting great things from him, expecting that he's going to give us strength, that he's going to give us grace, that he's going to fulfill every one of his promises. And I'm so thankful for that. And that's what this song is all about.
Trouble to come along my way. I know.
goes along with that theme that speaks again of some of the things that we have, the blessings that God has given us, that we live in a land of such wonderful opportunity and such resources, bountiful resources, and just the knowledge. And I know this could change, and our world is set up that it could just change tomorrow. But right now, we don't have any real fear of an invasion. And I'm not saying it couldn't happen. I'm just saying that we're not worried about, if we hear planes flying low, we don't really worry about whether there's bombs dropping. We just assume everything's okay. You know, just that alone, there's a lot of places in the world right this very moment where if they heard gunshots or bombs going off, they would run for shelter. There would be a siren somewhere that would alert them that there's rockets being fired or who knows what. And we don't live in that kind of fear. Now, I know some of our inner cities are like that, but I'm thankful that we can enjoy a measure of safety in America that we enjoy. We have so many things to thank God for, and this song just speaks to and enumerates some of those blessings that we have.
I have been blessed.
things up, but I want to again say thank you so very much, Pastor, for inviting us back and for all of you that showed up. And I know we're all hungry, at least I am, but you know, just before we sing this final song, I just want to remind us all that all of us will someday spend eternity somewhere. All of us will someday cross the line of worlds. Maybe it'll be through a resurrection, a rapture type event. But if he doesn't come in your lifetime, in my lifetime, our children's lifetime, if it's another 100 years or 1,000 years or 10 years, it could be tomorrow. Whatever it is, all of us will face eternity. And it's a sobering thought, something we don't care to think about maybe very much. We don't like to think about leaving our loved ones. We don't like to think about death or eternity. But it is a reality that we all must face. And I've tried to do my best to just remind folks wherever we sing of that reality, because we need to think about eternity and whether or not we've made preparations for eternity. And all of us will spend it somewhere, either in heaven or in everlasting punishment, Scripture teaches. And I want us to be together again in heaven. We've been singing this song as a final song now for a little while, but it just says, I want us to be together again in heaven. And that's our desire. We may never be able to be, the likelihood of us being ever able to gather like this morning, in this fashion, is the odds are next to impossible. But there is a place where we can gather together, and it's in heaven. And I hope that you've made your determination, your destiny, you've done what it takes to get there, and you're doing what it takes, living for him, so that we can be together someday.
Oh,
Bible says in Revelation 16, beginning in verse 14, and I'm not going to read all of the scripture. But when you go down to verse 15, it says, "Then another angel came out of the temple and called in a loud voice to him who was sitting on the cloud, 'Take your sickle and reap, for the time to reap has come, for the harvest of the earth is ripe.'" I want us all to be together in heaven, but I believe the harvest time is coming. The time is short. The days are evil. And we need to be about our Father's business. Well, I want to encourage you. There's two kinds of harvests that are mentioned. One is the harvest that joins the Son of Man in heaven. And the other harvest of the earth is done by the angels. And the grapes are gathered together for the great winepress of God's wrath. So when we talk about the harvest, there's two kinds. A harvest to eternal life or a harvest to the wrath of God. That's not my words, that's God's words. But there's a way this morning, if you don't know for sure where you're going to be in eternity, I want to tell you this morning, you can know for sure. Where we can all be together and experience the harvest of God into eternal life. Because God loves you. God loves you and want to be a part of the harvest to eternal life. Remember John 3:16, "For God so loved the world, but God so loved you, that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him would not perish, but have eternal life." But the problem is that sin separates us from God. It's because of sin that we will be caused to be part of the harvest that's gathered and thrown into the winepress of the wrath of God. Sin separates us from God. Sin determines our destiny. But God loves us. And God has provided a way for us to have eternal life. To have the assurance of eternal life. Where you can have a no-so salvation. Not a hope-so, but a no-so salvation. Where you can know for certain that if you die today or if Jesus comes, if the harvest began today and we ascended into heaven, you would go for sure. That's because God has provided the only way into eternal life and a relationship with him. And that's through the Lord Jesus Christ. 1 Corinthians 15, the Apostle Paul says, "This is the gospel, that Jesus Christ died for your sin according to the scripture, was buried, and that 3 days later rose again." And when you believe in him and understand what he has done for you, you receive the gift of God. That's what we need to do. If you have never received Jesus Christ, which simply means to trust him, as your Lord and Savior, and then to receive, surrender your life to him and receive from him eternal life, which is a relationship with him and a destiny in heaven. Ephesians 2:8 says that it's by grace that we are saved through faith. Not of ourselves, not by works. None of us can boast. If you're trusting in your good works, if you're trusting in coming to the Fuller Family Singers concerts, that somehow that's going to get you into heaven. We're not going to be together. They will. Because it's only through Jesus Christ, the Son of God, who died on the cross for us, was buried, and rose again. And you need to put your faith and trust in him. If you've never done that, this is Harvest Sunday. Be a part of the harvest, where the Son of God calls you home to be with him and live for him for closing hymn, which is an old invitation hymn. It's called Just As I Am. Some churches used to sing it for a half hour just to get somebody to come forward. Well, we're not going to do that. It was sung in almost every Billy Graham crusade. But we're going to sing it today, and we're going to sing verses 1, 3, and 5. So take your hymnal and turn to number 555. Sing your praises and encourage people to trust in you because, Father, the days are short and your coming is soon. So, Father, I ask in Jesus' name that you would move, continue to move in our hearts and lives. May the blessing of this day continue with us throughout this week and these coming days.